Today we're going to be making another of Sri Lankan delicacies, and this is Seeni Sambol. Seeni meaning sugar, and it has a lot of onions in it, and it's slightly sweetened. It's a side dish that can be eaten with hoppers, which you will see on another episode. So the two of those will really go well together. So to start off with the ingredients, I have here about 20 curry leaves, fresh curry leaves, 1 inch piece of cinnamon, and 5 cardamom pods. These are green cardamom. You also get the black cardamom, but we're using green. And I have these onions. They're the small red variety, and these are the traditional onions used in Sri Lanka for Seeni Sambol. However, it's not so common here, so we can go ahead and use the white onions, and I've sliced it here into the thin slices, and it gives a nice look and feel to the Seeni Sambol dish. So it's these same onions here that I have chopped. So the onions together is 1 pound of onions. I have here 1 teaspoon of Maldive fish chips, 1.5 teaspoon of sugar. We're going to be using salt to taste, and crushed red chili flakes, and 3 tablespoons of oil. So to begin, using a mortar and pestle, just move that aside, the cinnamon and the cardamom, we're just going to give it I just did is to break up the cinnamon and the cardamom into smaller pieces and open up the cardamom pods, and so that the seeds will add flavor to the Seeni Sambol. Heat up the stove to medium or medium high. So once the pan is heated up, just add in your oil. It looks like quite a bit of oil, but the onions will soak up a bit, and if you plan on keeping this, you can store it for a few days. Then the onion the oil helps to preserve it. So there's the oil. Then add in the cardamom and the cinnamon. And the curry leaves. Right away, you can add in all of the onion. Brown the onions, we can add in a little of the salt. So about a teaspoon. You need to keep stirring the onions just so that it doesn't get burned at one spot, and you're looking to have the onions caramelize a bit. turn brown, but not crispy. And now the onions are partly cooked, and you'll see that because of the quantity of the onions, the water starts to collect. And we don't want that. We don't want the onions to be soggy. So you gotta keep constantly stirring. And I've actually increased the heat back on my stove to high to help evaporate some of that water quickly. So it's partway cooked, and at this point I'm going to add in the Maldive fish chips. To give it a chance to cook as well. Now the Maldive fish chips can really be eaten raw because it's already been through the partial cooking process, but I like to have it cooked a little further just to ensure that you know, everything is cooked. Because I've used the white onions, and it wouldn't give me the authentic color. If you are going to use all white onions, you can cheat by adding in a little bit of turmeric powder. So because I've used the white onions here as a mixture, I'm going to add in just a pinch of the turmeric. A little bit, like a quarter teaspoon for the quantity I have here. If you had all white onions, then you could use half a teaspoon. When the onions have cooked through and are partially caramelized, we can add in the crushed chili flakes. I'm just going to put in here about a teaspoon and a half. Sri Lankans really like their food spicy, so if you think that this is not enough, then you can increase it, or if it's too much, then decrease it, of course. For us, this should be fine. I'm just going to fry it a little more. And then last, you would just add in the sugar. And mix that in. Sugar balances out the salt. So once you've mixed the sugar in, you can taste it just to see if the salt and the sugar balance in. Okay, so we've come to the end of this cooking process. After the taste test, I did add in a little bit more sugar because it wasn't sweet enough for me. So we started off with 1 teaspoon in the beginning. So I've added in another teaspoon or so. And you'll see that all the oil has been absorbed really by the onion. And it's not burnt, it's just caramelized, and it's really yummy. So we turn off the stove and we can plate it. And there you have it. It's Seeni Sambol, and it's wonderful to be eaten with Aappe, or even as a snack with bread or rost paan, which is another specialty in Sri Lanka. So stay tuned for more recipes, and if you have any comments or questions, please post them and I'll be happy to respond. Thank you for watching.